Today, I'm going to show you how to quickly set up Final Cut Pro to have the best overall editing experience and save time and storage space. I'm Rafael, and welcome to the channel where our goal is to always fix it in camera and then finesse it in post. And I always appreciate the early thumbs up because a frictionless editing experience should be the goal of every happy editor. And it all starts with your NLE set up properly right from the beginning. Today, we're looking at how I recommend setting up Final Cut Pro. But let me know if you'd like to see a Premiere or DaVinci version of this video. With Final Cut open, go up to the Final Cut menu and select Preferences. Or press Command Comma. Under the General tab, set Color Correction to Color Wheels. This will make Color Wheels your default color correction tool every time you go to make some color corrections. Under the Editing tab, turn off Show Reference Waveforms. This will show you ghosted audio that will just confuse you when you see it. Under Playback, turn off Background Rendering. Unless you have an older machine, this may be useful if you're adding lots of titles and effects, but this will create lots of render files and optimize media, which will eat up a lot of space. I like to keep it off and selectively render as needed. Turn off Create Optimized Media for Multicam Clips. You may not use Multicam Clips now, but you may in the future, and having this set off now will save you some frustration later with saving lots of space. Also, turn off If a Frame Drops, Stop Playback and Warn. It's better to keep the playback going and warn after, so make sure you keep the next one on for sure. Leave the rest as is. On the Import tab, select Leave in Place. This will save you the most amount of space. It won't duplicate footage and try to store it in two locations, on the drive and in the Final Cut library. Set keywords to from folders. So when you organize your footage before you import, you can drag your folders into the event and it will automatically keep them organized. So you won't have to organize it manually later. And this is a really good habit to get into right from the beginning, organizing your footage in the folders. Turn off Balance Color and Find People in Analyze Video. Turn off Create Optimized or Proxy Media. And fix audio problems, separate mono and group stereo, but keep remove silent channels. The rest will eat up lots of resources right off the top when you import your footage and slow down the start of your edit. You can always analyze the video and audio on specific clips from the Modify menu. Now, a note on optimized and proxy media. If you have an older machine again and you're working with a newer camera and have the space, leave this on because this will make the editing experience smoother for you. Just know that it will take up a lot of time and storage space. In the Destination tab, remove any of the ones that you know you won't use, but set up ones that you may want to use, like Save Current Frame, or like me, I have custom GIF exports that I use often. We'll talk about how to set those up in a future video. Close that out and then click on View right above the viewer. Open up the video scopes and select the vector scope. Turn on the skin tone indicator if it's not on, then turn on the RGB parade and turn on the IRE and set it to 70. That is the maximum recommended for your skin tone highlight setting. And you always want to keep your skin tones between 40 and 70 IRE. I did a whole video about perfect skin tones in Final Cut Pro. Make sure you check it out in the description. Click on View again and set your quality to Better Performance. This will give you the best playback on almost any machine, especially if you are stacking your footage and have multiple titles and effects. Set up a custom overlay, like the rule of thirds I have here, and set a custom keyboard shortcut to it. It's really useful when you want to lay out titles or compositions. You can create your own custom overlay, or you can download this specific one for free. There's a link in the description. And one of the best things that you can do is have your footage on a fast external SSD, like the Samsung T7 or the T5. Try to avoid having your footage on your startup disk. If your startup gets too full, your whole experience will be very slow. And it's ideal if your computer has at least 16 gigs of RAM if you're working on longer clips. Final Cut tries to put those longer clips into RAM or at least into swap memory. And here's some brief Final Cut terminology because it confuses a lot of people at first. A library is a collection of events which hosts multiple projects, which are essentially the main timelines that can have multiple videos, audio, images, as well as compound clips, multicam clips, but not other projects. These settings will get you editing faster without slowing down your machine and keep you happy with the amount of storage you'll save. In the next video, I'll show you how to set up your keyboard shortcuts to edit even faster. As always, thanks for watching. Give this video a big thumbs up. Subscribe. I'm Rafael. I'll talk to you soon. Bye for now.